Hey everybody, this is Hotcupocraig, and I'd like to welcome you back to another great installment of Super Mario Kart. I tried recording some Breath of Fire earlier. Apparently I need to do a little bit of level grinding, so we're going to do something that doesn't require level grinding. This. We're going to be playing the Flower Cup race, so it's going to be obviously a little more difficult than the last one, and we start all the way in the back row. I like taking that little shortcut right out the gate. It gets you around most of the pack, and, I mean, saves you a lot of heartache later on. Because most of the bigger characters take a coin from you every time you run into them, or most characters do it on the whole, actually. When you have no coins left, they actually just automatically spin you out as if you get hit by an attack item. Pretty annoying, so we're going to try to prevent that as much as possible. As you can see, no one likes Toad because he constantly, and yeah, if you hit a piranha plant, you spin out as well. But yeah, for some reason Toad is just hated by the video game community because he just decides to take last. And I'm just getting lazy and sliding off the track, but that's okay. We'll make the best of it. So how's everybody's day going so far? Good, hopefully. Wouldn't want any one of my viewers to have a bad day. That's not good. Alright, first race, super speed up motion, oh my god, craziness. And if Donkey Kong's big butt would get out of the way, we could end it. And we're gonna be taking first, yay, okay. As you can see, it's gonna be second is gonna be Yoshi, so unless I take second, Yoshi will be taking second for predominantly the rest of the, races. So we're gonna try to get this knocked out all in one video, just like the last cup. Hopefully we can. And now we're back to the ghost. Sorry about that. Ugh. So yeah, basically similar course, opposite turns. A little bit of difference in the speed ramp there at the end, but it's pretty close to the edge, so if you angle yourself right in any way, you're gonna die. And as you can see, the projectiles are already coming from a frantic Yoshi who knows that he's only popular because Mario rides him around. I mean, that's similar to Epona in Link, so Epona's pretty popular, I hear. It's a horse. I mean, who doesn't like horses? Anyone? Anyone? Alright, that's what I thought. So yeah, Breath of Fire. I didn't want to have to look up a walkthrough, but I didn't expect to struggle this early into the game either. Yeah, where I left the last video, started it, got wiped, and then, decided to play this for a minute, because I wasn't too happy about getting party wiped. I mean, all of two people, but come on. And we are going to take first in the ghost house. I know, still 50cc, still very easy, but we're working our way up. Slowly but surely. Round two is complete, and we are still at the top of the standings. I do like the music for this track. It's very calm, very relaxing. It's pretty much what you think this track would be like, except there are giant moles everywhere. Excellent. And they get stuck on your car, slow you down, and eat your soul. So the idea is not to hit them. But then they come up with this part where there's like a million of them. So just let off the gas a little bit, turn hard, and avoid them. If you do get one on your car, it's not terrible. Just LR, LR your way out of it, and you'll be fine. I mean, this isn't exactly Need for Speed or Twisted Metal, but it has elements of both games that I enjoy. And it's cartoony and it's, well, Nintendo characters. Who doesn't like Nintendo characters? Once again, anybody? Alright. Alright, lap 4, already underway. However, as you can tell, we're not getting as big of a lead on Yoshi as we were earlier. Obviously, the game does get more difficult as you go, so people are going to be getting closer and closer to me until they gradually just start taking over. Final lap. Alright, let's get this done. Don't start throwing eggs at me, Yoshi. Thanks to Princess Peach. Getting in my way all the time. See, Yoshi's right on our tail, so we're doing the best that we can. Oh, and an extra guy. I don't actually plan on using any of them. At least not on screen, because hopefully I won't get into that drastic of a situation in a race. Oh god, another Bowser level. This might be my least favorite Bowser level. I don't know. You do actually keep up your speed a little better if you swerve in between those, so that's what I tend to do. And then there's this little area. Not very hard, but when there's more people around, it'll obviously get more difficult. And when the thwomps start doing their thing, then it's going to get even more difficult. That's why you do have to really actually slow down a lot just to get through these areas. But it actually ends up totally being worth it. I know you're not going to set any land speed records, but it will pay off, because even the computer characters will slow down for the turns. They're not foolish. They're not, you know, they don't have different rules and applications of physics in the game than we do. But that's gonna kill me and let Yoshi pretty much catch up to me all the way. So, one mistake can cost you big in this race. You're not gonna lose it, I don't think, by any chance. But unless I quit being foolish and actually, you know, drive properly. That actually worked out a little bit to my benefit. Alright, that was pretty much the most awkward set of jumps I've ever done. Alright, it should be the final lap, and it is. I'm just going to hold on to this red shell in case someone passes me somehow. I'm not sure how, but they might. So, as you get higher up in the races, the courses become a little more ridiculous, and that's actually when it becomes a lot of fun to play. I'm not saying that it's not fun to play right now, it's just these are pretty basic tracks. It's not nearly anything compared to Mario Kart Wii, because obviously that game's just ridiculous. So yeah. Final race. Once again, we're in the no pressure situation. We don't have to win. I'd like to, but not mandatory. So the competitors can do whatever they want and cheat in any way they see fit. Normally, when you're out in front, for some reason, the game has actually made it so you only get bad items. Coins, bananas, you don't ever get the lightning bolt, you don't ever get red shells. Very rarely you'll get red shells. You'll get green shells because the game wants you to have green shells. But don't worry, see, like I said, green shells. And then you have Yoshi who's just throwing crap at you every single second. Oh my gosh. Okay, get back on course. Forget you, Yoshi, I'm gonna cut through the dirt. Now, see how many things Yoshi has thrown at me at this point? It's ridiculous. He's thrown 3 projectiles. And I... like, that's ridiculous. He's gonna keep doing it, though, so let's just get ready for it. Like I said, you get bananas to help defend your already adequate lead. Actually, that helped a lot. It knocked him back a couple of paces, so... pretty helpful. And now we see Toad, everybody's favorite little guy, just in last place, like normal. I think I will play the next cup just as Toad to give him some wins. Because I don't mind Toad. I mean, he's more of a sidekick to Mario than anybody. And you see what can happen when you take your eye off the prize just for a second. But because I hit the speed up pad, he did not. I somehow pulled it out of my hat. Alright, we're running a little long on time with this video, but just wanted to get to the final screen. And then we're gonna end it, and I'll probably do some level grinding on Breathfire. So yeah, that's gonna be fun. And we get the golden cup, and I'm taking this fish out with my double-barreled bottles of champagne. And that's it. That's another lovely installment of Super Mario Kart by Hotcupocraig. I'll see you guys later. Have a good day.